they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. In our readings, we notice that the scriptures encourage us to realize that this life is not the end and that we are all on a journey. We have a purpose for being here, some for a shorter while than others, but the Lord God who created us has put us on this earth for a purpose. Many times this purpose is to serve other people. It is like as though he asks us to pour ourselves out to others. And in a particular way we see this in parents who, through their bringing up a family, they literally empty themselves out to those they bring into this world, both physically or biologically, but also by what they teach them. One of the things I think I remember that Larry mentioned was that when he asked the mother what is the greatest accomplishment she has done, her reply was, raise children to be honest, hardworking, educated, and law-abiding citizens. And we see how she has done that in the many, many things she has done, being an artist, being a craftswoman. In everything that she did, she was concentrating it towards the bringing up of her children. And she has succeeded. It's not for us, perhaps, to say whether it was enough, but that which we see is what we bring to the Lord God, and we admire it and ask that the Lord may reward her for the hard work she has done and for her achievements that she has achieved. A number of things were mentioned in what Larry and Priya, and I'm sure all the other brothers and sisters remember of their mother. One is summarized the fact that she looked a very humble person. I didn't know her for a long time, except for the 3 years I've been here. And she hardly said anything, but you could see in her the warmth of a mother. You could see in her. In fact, one time I went to visit her to bring her communion. I remember after we had had our prayers, there was a picture on the wall, and she said, you know who that is on the wall? I said, that's my mother, Agnes. And I was really very touched, because she said that she has a picture on her mother of those who are here present now today. In her, we saw motherhood. And even though